The Insta360 X3 has a 1/2-inch 48 megapixel sensor. It shoots up to 5.7K 30 in 4K 60 in 360 mode. It has awesome flow state stabilization. It's waterproof, it has active HDR, and it has a single lens mode, which means you don't always have to shoot in 360. And with that mode, you have a new mode called Me Mode, which I'll talk about a little bit later on. One of the biggest reasons why I actually wanted to upgrade from the Insta360 ONE X2 to the X3 was the fact that the X3 has a much bigger screen. And you might think that that's, okay, a bit of a strange thing to want to upgrade for, but honestly, the X2 screen is so small that when you're trying to look at the footage or just swipe through the menu, it's just a bit of a faff, it's really fiddly. And so having this much larger screen makes things so much easier. Of course, you can attach your phone if you want to, but if you actually don't want to attach your phone just to quickly preview the footage that you just shot, you can do it all on the screen and you can see it perfectly fine. It works absolutely great. One of the things that I was never really impressed about with the ONE X2 was the fact that the audio just didn't sound very good. Whereas with the X3, there's definitely a massive improvement.
So this audio, it's coming directly from the Insta360 X3, and from what I've actually heard, it sounds pretty decent. But just like the ONE X2, you can attach an external microphone, you just need a few bits and pieces for it. And I won't really make a video.
You could totally just get away with filming directly on the X3 and recording your audio directly into the X3, and it would sound fine. But if you did want to get better audio, then attaching something like a Rode Wireless Go 2 would be great. And there is a specific accessory that you can get to attach it so that it doesn't protrude past the lenses, so it's not seen in the frame when you have it. And it's much like the X2, but you actually need a different mic adapter, because the one from the X2 doesn't fit the one from the ONE X2 doesn't fit the X3. So that is just something to be mindful of.
You really do get some funny looks when you're using a 360 camera. It's stuck out on a pole. Everyone's very curious about what it is and what you're doing.
The next thing is the video quality seems like it's improved quite a lot. I feel like the X2, when you were shooting in conditions where it wasn't very bright, it was very mushy. And that's not to say that the X3 isn't mushy, but the ONE X2 seemed mushier. And also when you're cropping into the footage as well, the ONE X2 just didn't have as good a quality as the X3 does. So I feel like the image quality is definitely a lot better. And I feel like the best test for me is whether I actually take this with me all the time, and I do, because I feel like whatever footage I get from it, I am going to use it. Whereas with the X2, I was kind of like, I'm not entirely sure that I would actually use that footage, because it didn't actually look that great, especially if I was then going to punch in further to try and see, get closer to what I was doing or what I was filming. So there's a single lens mode on here, which is another reason why I really like this. And even though the X2 did have a mode where you could just film like using a regular action camera, this has a single lens mode which you can use also for POV shots, and I found it actually works really well. Although I feel like because you're capturing the footage as though someone's looking at you, you don't get the POV where you're kind of someone's seeing it from your perspective. So I don't know if that's because of how I had the camera, I might need to play around a bit with that. But even so, it's kind of like someone's showing you what they're doing, which I kind of like that perspective as well. So all you have to do is just mount the X3 on like a chest mount, or you can have it on a bike mount if you want, but I found it's actually quite heavy to have in your mouth. But having it on a chest mount works really well, and then you can just do what you're doing. It captures quite a wide field of view as well, so you don't have to worry about whether you are actually in frame. (Music) Another great thing is that with the single lens mode, you have me mode, and that means that you can literally just hold the camera out in front of you and it will record everything vertically. It will keep you in the frame in the center. As long as you keep yourself kind of in the middle, it will keep you in the frame. And one of the things that you can actually do in the studio app is kind of just reframe it a little bit. So if you feel like you're a little bit off, or you didn't quite, you're a little bit out of frame, or you're not quite in the center, then you can actually reframe it a little bit in the studio app, which is awesome. But it just means that if you want to film yourself, you're vlogging, or you want to do any vertical shooting, then you can do that and it will capture you fully and keep you in the frame, which is great. And finally, this isn't something that's new with the X3 specifically, because all Insta360 360 cameras do this, where you can literally just point this camera anywhere and then reframe it later on. So if you don't necessarily know what you want to film, or you're out and about and you're vlogging and you want to capture that, and then you want to capture that, you want to capture what's behind you, what's in front of you, you can literally just put it on the selfie stick, extend the selfie stick, hold it up, and then just walk around, and then later on in post you can then reframe where you want it to be.
The other thing that I really love about the X3 is the fact that it's not tiny, but it's small enough to get into really small places and get some really creative shots.
So one of the other things that I actually forgot to mention, which I guess is a little bonus reason, is the fact that this works so well as a behind the scenes camera. If you go out filming by yourself and you do videos, YouTube videos, whatever, and you don't have anyone with you and you really want to film what you're doing, or not just shooting videos, just anything really, you can literally just put this down, press record, leave it running, and then later on you can reframe everything that you want to. So this works perfectly as a little mini crew in your pocket. So yeah, capturing BTS, it's fantastic, and I've used it so much for that. It's coming so handy just for that alone. So I would definitely recommend it if you're filming by yourself or doing anything by yourself and you want to capture BTS of what you're actually doing. This was less a review of the X3 and mainly just my reasons why I really like it and why you might actually like it as well. So anyway, review or not, I hope you found it useful, and if so, do give the video a like because it helps out the channel. But thank you for watching. I'll put a link in the description so you can check it out, because you can get a free selfie stick if you use the link in my description, which also helps out the channel and doesn't cost you any extra. So yeah, check it out, and thanks for watching. Catch you on the next video.